My name is Nur Azilatul Mustafida Wahyudi. I'm from 10 Science 1. I am option 27. I will tell you a story from Indonesia. The title is Crying Stone. Once upon a time, there was a widow and her only daughter living in hinterland of West Kalimantan, Indonesia. The widow was just an old woman, while her daughter was a charming girl whose name was Darmi. But life in decrepit hut. They lived poor since the widow's husband passed away. He was gone, leaving no inheritance to the family. Consequently, to fulfill their needs, they were forced willy-nilly to work much harder. However, Darmi was not a hard worker, totally different from her mother. She was a lazy girl who spent almost all of time dressing up and adoring of her reflection on the mirror. One of her bad habits was showing of her beauty on the local people living in surrounding. She never wanted to have her mother working at the field. If the mother asked, then may refuse.
Girl, will you help me at the field now?
Mother asked. No, I won't. I don't go to there. I'm afraid. My skin turns dark. Darmi answered her mother without looking of her. You look me work alone, don't you? The mother said. Mom, everyone know that you are an old woman while I'm a pretty young girl. So people will attract it to me and not to you. This is why I prefer staying at home to working outside, because I am waiting a rich boy to propose me get married with me. The mother, very speckless, was heard that. If this was, she was stricken by a light, realizing that her daughter didn't respect her off at all. And then she went to the field alone, and Darmi stayed at home. Worse, Darmi used to beg money from her mother. Soon after, she went back from work. In fact, she earned too little to meet their daily need. Mom, where's the money? No, I won't give this to you. We need this to buy some food, the mother said. But I'm running out of my fish powder. I don't have any more, Mom. I need this to buy a new one. The Darmi's mother was so angry to her daughter, but she repressed it. Darmi's bad habit towards her mother occurred almost every day. The mother worked too hard at the field while Darmi stayed at home. And when the mother back home, Darmi's mother was going to a nearest market from her home. Darmi knew this, and she got her mother to buy some cosmetics. However, her mother didn't know anything about cosmetics. She asked Darmi to go with me, so you can choose which one that you want, girl, the mother said. I don't want to go with you, Darmi answered. But I don't know which one. Then Darmi gave up. She followed her mother to go to the market. Okay, Mom, I will go to with you. But please, you have to walk behind me, said Darmi. Why, girl? The mother will ask me to walk along with an old woman like you. Look at me. I'm a graceful girl. So, I want people to leave me because they know you are my mother, Darmi explained. But then look for goods in the market. Darmi's mother walked behind her daughter. She broke a plastic bag containing the things that from there. Actually, they between a mother and a girl, but somehow look country. Dummy wore a legend clothes and walked gracefully, while her mother wore a worn-out clothes with rumbling face. Along the way in the market, many greeted Dummy, and some of them asked who the old woman was. In a moment, Dummy met her friend.
Hi, Dummy. Where are you going?
Around here. I wish I cooked something good here, Dummy said. Then, who does one? Is that your mom? One of her friends asked.
No, of course. There's my mate at Postgolf.
Dummy's mother was totally shocked to hear that all. She could not believe this word came out from her
mouth. Dummy met a man who he asked the old woman with her.
Dummy admitted she was her maid. Within a taking answer, Dummy's mother could no longer restrain her anger. Soon after Dummy said that word, the mother stopped and took a seat on the sidewalk.
Why do you stop?
Dummy questioned her mother, but she didn't call her mom.
Hey! You are listening to me.
She should once more, because the mother was just silent. The mother kept silent, ignoring call of her daughter who had heard her. Since then, Dermy's mother mumbled with her hands looked up the sky. She was reciting prayers to God, see that doctor was cursed to be a stone.
Hey, old woman, what are you doing?
Dummy kept stubborn. Dummy's mother intended to answer. She kept praying to God upon a curse towards her daughter. All of a sudden, the sky turns dark. He looked thunder rather back and forth. The rain fell heavily. At the time, Dummy couldn't move her foot anymore. Gradually, her foot turned into black stone that later uncovered her entire body.
Mom! Mom! What's happening to me?
Finally, she called her mother mom.
I'm sorry, Mom! I'm so sorry!
She cried loudly. Everything went on. The curse upon Dummy disobedience had happened. The stone covered almost all her body. When the stone almost reached her head, Dummy shed tears. All the people passing by the market saw this. Like wish, they watched her girl crying. The weather returned as normal. Now the stone had covered Dummy's entire body. This disobedient girl, what a miracle! The stone, through the prison, keeps putting water in crying girl. Some people took the stone and put on the corner of the market. Since the time, people cut the stone, the crane.
That's a story for crane. Thank you for watching.